What's happening, YouTube? This is Lamari here, bringing you another live narrated match from the Super Speed Doubles Wi-Fi tournament. So let's get straight into it. Obviously don't have a lot of time to choose things. So this is back to using my original team that I was using in the first few battles. So a lead with Double Intimidate, and this time changed up to Rotom Wash in the back. So a fairly interesting tournament, especially when you can't see what your opponent is bringing, because you've got no idea. No idea at all. And obviously, you have to go with what your gut feeling tells you to choose. So, okay, so it says an Amoongus and Zumarill. Okay, so pretty much from the get-go, this is a decent, pretty decent matchup for me. Because that Azumarill is at minus two. So, I believe this turn, I'm going to double up on the Amoongus. Because I want that thing gone. So, if Amoongus is not gone for Protect, then I'm in a pretty good position. Yeah, so I went for Rage Powder anyway, so... Okay, so this probably means that the Azumarill wants to go for plus 6 Billy Drum, and I miss my Fire Blast, which is not good. So we'll see how this much this does. Oh, it's actually still an Urko, even at minus 2. Okay. That wasn't too pleasant. I was expecting it's not Urko. Alright, so at this stage we're going to switch out, we're going to bring Rotom Wash. And... ooh. I think at this stage I'm going to be forced to go for a T-Bolt or a Hydro Pump onto the Amoongus. Because the T-Bolt is too obvious. Onto a Azumarill. So it would make sense that he'd go for Hydro Pump a second time. Sorry, he'd go for Rage Powder a second time. So thankfully that's Amoongus gone. We'll see how much this can do at minus two. Not a lot, but then again it's also not enough to get me down to my Citrus Berry, unfortunately. So a bit of a mixed bag there. So he brings in the scissor. So I think this time I'm going to Iron Head the Azumarill, and I'm going to Will-O-Wisp the scissor. So thankfully I get my burn off onto the scissor right away. And having the Azumarill at minus 2 is also pretty helpful as well. So this should get me down to Citrus Berry range, which it does, thankfully. Although that Azumarill is also in a range to take me out, I think. So Iron Head, yes, I pick up the flinch, which is excellent. Okay, so this has brought my position... yeah, this has put my... Yeah, it's certainly put me in a better position. Oh, a rage quit. A rage quit. Okay, I'm definitely saving a rage quit, but yeah, these rage quits do happen, as you can see on my DS. So yeah, it's actually the second rage quit I've had happen when I was playing before. I wasn't sitting down doing a live recording. I had a rage quit happen. So yeah. They happen, and all you can do is smile at them, because your opponent was saying that, you know, they were shit, or they got haxed out and they just could care less about the game. So, yeah, I mean, it wouldn't have made a difference in the long run in this position, in my opinion. Yes, Rotom was probably at a range where it could have got KO'd, I think. slim chance of survival and slim chance of KO, but I mean, Azumarill's at minus two, so. But at this stage, I'm babbling, but again, thank you for watching, and until next time, take care.